Welcome to the Hallam & Titan Academy, the workshop for the professionals. I'm Barry, this is Mark.
Hi.
Today's question we've been posed is, how do you create an environmental seal using heat shrink shapes on a cable jacket? Our session today is a practical demonstration, so we don't just talk, we do the actual demonstration for you. We'll talk you through the process, and by the end of it, we're sure you'll be confident to be able to carry out the process yourself. We need to abrade the cable, Mark.
So why are we abrading the cable, Barry?
To give it a key in preparation for the installation of the boot and the adhesive. So can I have some razor paper, please?
Certainly. Can you explain what you mean by a key?
Yep. The key is to rough the surface up.
Right. Okay. I see.
Yep. So if you have two slippery surfaces, when you try to bond them, they will slide. If you have two rough surfaces, they will grip.
Okay. Is there a reason why you are actually abrading it or roughing it up?
Yes.
Going up and down and not around the cable?
There is a reason for that, and I'll explain it as soon as I finish this. And we've abraded the shape as well. Okay. So we also abrade the shape because that's part of the bond process.
Right. Okay.
Now these we do circular.
So why is that then, Barry?
One reason is it's very difficult to shuffle inside, and you can also roll the abrasive paper up. And it fits nicely in the legs, like
right,
so.
Okay,
But the key to the keying is this. This has been abraded this way.
Yeah.
And this has been abraded that way. So when the two come together, they create a cross.
Oh, I see.
So you get an even stronger bond.
Right, I understand that. Yeah.
Good.
That's very
so now
good.
We need to dry wipe them with some paper.
And I assume we dry wipe it to get rid of all the dust.
Correct.
That's created.
Yep. So we need some adhesive tape.
Yes, I've got some here.
Great stuff.
That's
Thank
already
you.
Prepared.
We'll switch on the heat gun to warm it up in advance. So we have our mark.
Yeah, when you wrap this around, Barry, isn't it just going to unwrap?
No, because we have a clever little top tip. Screwdriver, please.
Certainly.
This is a hot melt tape.
Yeah.
So when you heat the screwdriver, we can tack onto the tape.
I see, so you tack the tape together
Correct.
So it doesn't come unwrapped.
So I recommend anybody who installs this sort of product does that for ease of installation.
Right, I see, yes. Yeah, because you wouldn't want to come in unwrapped, would you, when
No.
you're trying to put the heat shrink shape on.
Like so.
So that's all nicely tacked on now, so it won't come unwrapped.
Okay, now we need our protective wear.
I assume you need the protective wear because it gets hot.
Yes, and you're dealing with a hot heat gun. So, so we slide the shape on over the legs, like so. Over the body, and there we have the tape.
Does it matter if the tape is showing?
No, that's perfect, because now you know you have, the tape is a 25 millimeters wide,
right.
So you know you have just as much inside as you have outside, so you'll get a very good bond.
Okay.
So the heat gun is already pre-warmed from our tacking process. So we start in the center of the shape.
Okay, do you need to pre-warm the heat gun?
It's a good thing to do, because if you start using a heat gun when it's not up to temperature, you're wasting time and you're not providing the correct heat source to allow it to shrink. Because these shapes need around about 225 degrees to 250 degrees to get them to shrink at around about an inch.
So is that what the gun is actually set
to? Yes, so the gun is set on setting 7, which is on this particular gun is what we require.
So it's really important that it's a good quality heat gun.
Yes.
And it's well calibrated.
Yes. Yep, you should calibrate your heat gun at least once a year, minimum. So it's starting to recover now.
So I can see it's changing shape. What do you mean by recovering? Is that changing shape?
Yes. So when we manufacture the product, it's in a certain form. And within the factory, we then reheat them and stretch them or expand them.
Right.
Into the supplied form, and I'll explain that to you once we finish this process. So once that becomes fluid, it will run, seal up the end of the cable,
right,
and create the environmental seal that we're looking for our customers.
Can you explain an environmental seal again?
So an environmental seal can be anything up to IP69.
Right.
In this particular case, it's around about an IP65, 66, because it's not completely impervious to chemicals. It's purely aimed at a water and environmental, so dust, dirt, that sort of thing.
So dust and moisture.
Correct,
and
yeah. Dirt,
yeah.
So this is perfect for being used on low voltage, up to 1,000 kilovolts, and being buried in the ground.
So will it be ready to use as soon as you're finished?
Yeah, pretty much. Once it cools down to room temperature, it will be ready to install. So you can see that's recovered nicely now.
Yes, it's changed shape totally.
Yes.
From what you put on there.
So let me explain the memory and the recovery. So this is our finished part.
Yeah.
So we've got a recovered shape, adhesive either end, sealed well, so no moisture or dirt can get in.
So that adhesive at the end doesn't matter?
Nope, that's perfect because it adds a layer of protection.
Oh,
so
I
this
see,
is okay. How we supply them at the factory.
Yeah.
And this would be the supplied profile and this is the recovered profile. So you can see the difference in the memory process.
So the memory means it's been molded and then expanded?
Correct, yes. So it provides a perfect seal to the cable once it's installed. So it allows you to install the boot over a smaller cable sizes. And then when you recover it, it shrinks to your recovered cable diameter.
Oh, I see. Okay.
So you then have a perfect seal.
Very good, yeah.
Okay. So if you enjoyed this demonstration, please like us and subscribe to our page. And myself and Mark will see you again soon. Bye.
Bye.